Hello, Naomi.
Hello, Clinton.
I see we're settling into this space, so I'd like to check with you. You just put something in your hand. Can you show me what it is or whatever? Can you just, are you willing to not have that right now in your hands? I have nothing in my hands. Nothing up my sleeve.
Me too. No sleeves. Yeah.
Will you make sure you have your energetic center on your physical center and make it this grounding cord between your center and the middle of the earth? And will you tell me the color of your grounding cord?
Peach.
Mine is yellow. Will you make one more click and make this bubble of personal space around yourself? And I just let you know I have a additional, I've clicked one more time to make an energetic space between where I am now, which is this La Gomera Island off the coast of Africa, and where you are now, which is someplace off the coast of Yucatan or on the coast of the Yucatan Peninsula, Mexico. Mm-hmm. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. Puerto Morelos.
PM town.
Okay. All right. You please open your eyes. And do you, what can I do for you?
I've been giving a lot of thought to what I wanted to do here, which could be a process in itself, the whole why that would be an issue for me. And something I'd like to work with is that I have this dark space inside. And yeah. That and another theme is that I have really intense fear that comes up if I go in water or if I try to tell, especially a man, that I'm angry, or if I'm around a group of especially privileged children. It's this intense fear. And when I'm alone, actually, there's always this percentage of fear. Like I sense that something is going to go wrong, or, and right now when I say that, I feel sadness. And on top of all of that, I do this sense of confusion of like not knowing and not being grounded and not knowing where to start. And I'm quite tired of that. I'm not always like that, but too often. Like wanting someone to tell me what to do or how it works or give me permission or something like that.
You have tissues and towel and bucket nearby?
Yeah.
Good. That's five different processes you named. I would respect each one of those things enough to give them each their own process space. That would be my proposal. So when you bite your lips right now, this is a way of numbing out feelings, and particularly it numbs out the low level feelings, which have so much value. The low level feelings are these instantaneous. So your emotional body was giving you clarity and possibility right then about, I said, these are five separate processes that you can respect with dignity and go into. Each one is a journey and a treasure path, and you bit your lips to stop letting the flow come to you. Why is that? What's that about? Why would you want to block that?
It's something about the story I told myself was that my lip itched, and the It's numbing a fear and sadness mixture.
I'm less interested
in which I'm actually.
I'm less interested in your analysis than I am in the journey. So, are we going there? Is that where we're going, or where are we going? Try to not bite your lips. Try to not swallow down the
fear. Where do I?
Where are we going? Try to not bite your lips or swallow down.
I want to go to.
Sorry?
Yeah.
I didn't hear the last
thing. I want to go to the thing that makes me bite my lip or.
I think it would be better to do that, more effective to do that than to go into the dark thing yet. Because.
Oh.
It requires kind of a free access to high and low level intensity, anger, sadness, fear, and joy to handle the dark thing. And it'd be, I think, just better to handle the why you're biting your lips, which creates confusion. That's that thing. It's the one that's the confusion and probably the low level fear that you have ongoingly carry in your body. You shut your eyes. Go ahead, shut your eyes. What do you hope to accomplish with that that low-level fear there all the time? What do you hope to accomplish by that? What is it about?
What do I hope to accomplish by having that fear?
Yes. Really, what is it about? I don't want to answer. When I ask you a question, I'm indicating a direction to go. I do not want an answer. I don't want anything from your mind right now. This would be just useless. I would like your heart to talk. I would like you to go with me, take me on this journey. I'm holding space where you can have clarity and possibility to go in places where you have not gone before. There's treasures in there. But if I ask you a question, you go in your mind, then you're back in school, we get nothing. Okay? So I'm saying you are carrying this low intensity fear around all the time. What's that about? What's the point? What do you get? And then you go into it, go into the low level fear and let it talk to you. You know, it'll say, I have to be here because of whatever, whatever.
I have fear because I think that I need to give the answers that you want to hear. I have fear because I feel this magnetic thing in which my bodily sensations, like the answers from within, are not important.
The answers from within are not important.
Yeah.
How could you live like that? How could that be? How did you do this to yourself?
I had to find a way to explain why I felt so much pressure and why I felt so afraid.
To who?
I'm thinking of my father.
And if you did not explain what happened, what would happen?
I wouldn't be trusted. I would be judged and I would be beaten, and I was afraid that.
What did he beat you with? Try to not bite your lips. Feel free to blow your nose or whatever, but do not bite your lips, all right?
Yes.
This is where we're going. We're going, notice how your voice totally changed. You bite your lips, you go numb, and your voice gets plastic again. Goes back to the fake, controlled, monitored voice. What did he beat you with?
It was more my mother who beat me.
What did she beat you with?
A spoon or her hands.
What kind of a spoon?
A big wooden spoon in the corner of the living room.
Thank you.
And my father once threw a chair at us. And when I think of my father, I'm way more numb.
Let's go where it goes. So how old were you when you first started getting chairs thrown at you and the wooden spoon?
Around 7.
I think it was before then. But this sounds calm, Naomi. Just keep going. Yes, keep going. Yes, let it get bigger. Let it get bigger.
No.
What is this thing you're seeing? What are you seeing? You said no. What are you seeing?
It's my mother was coming to beat me. Or it's my father who just keeps going away. He just keeps going away.
Yes, yes.
He keeps going away.
You keeps going one time or keeps going different times over and over?
Different times over and over and far away. And
it happened a lot.
Yeah.
Naomi,
and he leave.
What? Go ahead.
He leaves us alone with my mother, and she doesn't know how to handle us.
How many were you?
3.
Were you brothers or sisters?
Brother, and then me, and then sister.
Okay, you're the middle. Did any one of you get beaten more?
Sometimes my brother would get beaten because he would ask for attention.
See, here's what's interesting. You know, you're smart. You know that. So you've been smart the whole time. You were smart enough to not get hit. Why did you want to get beaten?
Why didn't I want to get beaten?
Why did you want to get beaten? You're smart enough to see it once or twice, go, okay, I see how this goes, not doing this anymore. You're smart enough to figure that out. Why did you want to get beaten?
So that I could believe that I was living in hell.
Mm-hmm. Why did you want to believe you were living in hell?
There's something about I wanted to find an explanation for that it felt dark.
Is this the same dark thing you were talking about before? Try to let the feelings up, Naomi.
Pardon?
Try to let the feelings up. It looked like there was a feeling right there, and it looked like you bounced into your mind instead of going with the feeling. That. How old were you when you noticed the dark?
I think 6 or 7, or maybe even before.
How did you notice it?
I felt it, and I saw it in my mom, and I saw it in my brother, and I saw it in how we were together at the table.
Keep going. Try to not block the feelings. They're way bigger than this, really. Naomi, let it fall apart. There's a construct. There's some kind of story world that you believed in the whole time, and you're biting your lips. Your body's screaming at you, and you're biting your lip, letting it come through. Keep going. It is this big. It is. Which feeling is it mostly?
Fear.
Don't go back in the plastic voice, okay? Let your heart talk. It's mostly fear. And sometimes you go into what?
Sadness.
And also?
Anger.
Yeah. Stick with the fear right now. All right? You can feel. You can inner navigate. When the anger comes, put it on a shelf. When the sadness comes, put it on a different shelf. We can go there later. But if you mix them in all the time, we don't get the full fear, and we need that. We need the full fear. Doing great. Just keep going. When the sadness comes up, put it on the side. Fear, anger comes up, put it on the side. And let the fear lead you. Okay, we need to go there. It's time to go there. At the table, you said you could see it sitting at the dining table. What's happening at the dining table with your mother and your brother? Try to not cover up your eyes with the cloth or your hands or anything. Just let it come. Just fall in. You don't have to figure it out. Don't hyperventilate. This is not going to help. Do not hyperventilate. It's just fear. Let it take you. It's your fear. It has intelligence.
I'm in this depressed, mixed thing, like I'm hiding.
Try to not analyze it or compact it into some way. Just let it be raw and let's go there. Yeah, like that. You're at the table with your mother and your brother. What's going on? What is that? Try to not bite your lips. Is there food on the table? It's a meal space.
It's a meal space.
Is it breakfast, lunch, or dinner?
It's lunch.
Your dad there?
Yeah.
And your sister also?
Yeah, but she's a little, yeah.
Okay. Here you're sitting there. Point to your mom. Where is she sitting? Good. And where's your brother? Okay. What's going on?
My brother's depressed and he's being criticized.
By her or who?
By my father.
Let it come up. Let the feelings come up. You tightened up your throat when you said my father. You tightened up your throat and blocked the feeling.
My father's telling him that he's eating like a pig.
Yeah.
And I feel so much hate and disgust coming from my father.
Yeah.
And I think I have so much repressed anger and I don't know how to get it out.
Go ahead, fists. Put your hands in fists. Louder. Words.
Oh, fuck you!
Keep going. Keep going.
You're being so fucking mean!
Keep going.
You're being such an asshole!
Yes. What's not okay? Yes, why is that not okay?
Because my brother started to hate himself!
Yes, keep going, keep going.
I want to protect him, but I don't know how!
Yes. Say that.
And I'm trying to be a fucking good girl so that you won't treat me the same!
Yes. Also say I'm angry. Also say it.
I'm angry! And I'm afraid to be angry!
Not anymore.
Not anymore! I'm angry!
Yes.
I'm angry because it's fucking not okay to show disgust to your own child.
Yes.
It's not okay to leave them alone.
Good, you're doing great.
It's not okay that I fucking taught myself to be a good girl because I was afraid of you!
Yes. Go. Keep saying it.
I was afraid of you! And you just were so fucking self-centered with your fucking job! And you hated my mother for her feeling bad!
Yes.
And she sent you on a therapy and didn't let her!
Yes.
You were too fucking self-consumed and too fucking concerned with your fucking self-image!
Yes. Doing super. No. Take the other feeling out. You mixed something else in. Take it out. Pure anger right now. Pure anger. What did you mix in? What did you mix? Yeah, do not mix fear in. Fear is valuable. You don't want to mix it. Anger is valuable. You don't want to mix it. Keep going. You're doing super with that. Keep saying the words. Say the words. Don't shut your mouth.
I am angry. I'm fucking angry.
Because now.
Because you just chose to hide like a fucking coward.
Yes.
And you blamed everything on my mother.
Yes.
I hate you for that.
Yes.
You're such a fucking coward. And you pretend to be connected, but you're not. You're feeling too fucking scared to show any fucking feelings to anybody. And then we have to be happy. We have to be happy that you pay food or that you do that kind of thing for us. And we're not allowed to say anything else. And then I have to be happy to protect you so that you don't feel bad about yourself, you fucking asshole.
Yeah.
And then you help people, your job, and you're not even able to connect to your fucking family, you fucking idiot!
Yes.
And we're not allowed to say anything because you're the authority! And I always have to adapt to you!
Saying that's over.
And that's fucking over! I'm gonna fucking not no longer disempower myself. I'm fucking stopping to fucking disempower myself to fucking please you. I'm done pleasing you and pleasing anybody. Yeah. Fuck off. I'm done hiding behind my fears.
In particular, fears of what?
Fears of that I have to be small to not make the authority feel bad about itself.
How, don't open your eyes. How is that going to show up? If you're done hiding, if you're done being small, so some authority does not have to, what did you say?
To not make the authority feel bad about itself. Yeah. To not make it uncomfortable, to not like feel that it's being questioned.
So if this is going to show up in your life now, which authorities are going to freak out around you?
Men.
All men. Hi. You're doing super.
Thank you.
Why did you say thank you?
Because that's an automatic response.
Not allowed here. I'm going to try again. You were doing super. It was really super. It was clear. I could see you inner navigating. You were cutting loose with this rage that's been in there that whole time. And when sadness would come in, you put it to the side. When fear would come in, you put it to the side. And stay with the anger and you would give it words. This is how it goes. It's exactly like that. So you were doing super.
Yes.
All right, God. All right, so thank you for doing super. That was very fine. You made a comment and you said that you were able to feel the fear before and the sadness before, but you were not able to bring in the anger. You were not able to go with anger before. You remember you said that? Okay, well, you just broke through that. You completely shattered that whole thing. When you said this is over, when you said I'm not adapting anymore, like all of that stuff was totally, it creates a new future for you. I think my last question for you was something like, which external authority figures are now going to freak out because you are no longer being adaptive to make them not feel bad about themselves. Remember I asked you that? Which ones? And you said men. Then the whole system crashed down. Okay, I said which, what did you say? I said which men?
I said men that want to decide everything for someone else, everything for other people. I said powerful women. And I said children, but I think I need another process for that because that one's different.
Naomi, I'd like to ask you a question. Are you a powerful woman?
I am when I don't make myself unpowerful.
It's a different answer. I mean, see, if you can make yourself unpowerful, then you're not powerful. What I'm saying is, when you walk into a space, is it your space? When you walk into a space, are you holding space, even if somebody else is? Is it?
Yeah.
Is it when you speak, do people listen? When you speak, do you confront reality? Do you face into what's being hidden, or do you put the poop on the table? Is this your natural way of being with people and possibilities? That's what I'm asking.
I do in some situations, and in other situations, I squelch myself.
Okay.
Because I allow the environment to tell me if it's okay or not, if they are ready with it for it or not, if they're comfortable with it or not.
Who can possibly be comfortable with reality? Who can be comfortable with possibility? Who's comfortable with transformation? Who's comfortable with evolution? That's an impossible thing to happen. It does not work to be comfortable with life. I mean, you know, security or comfort is a promise that you cannot make for people if life is going to happen. I mean, you can play dead, but I don't know how old you think you are or how much time you think you have left to play dead, but I don't know. Why would you be in a place where you're playing dead?
Because I believe I'm not powerful.
That's why I was asking you the question. So part of your homework, part of your experiment to do is to check with 20 people in the next couple of weeks, 20 different people, write their name in your beat book, make a list of 20 people, call them up and say, I'm struggling with my self-image. And on a scale of 1 to 10, where 1 is a wet noodle and 10 is a powerful adult present woman, please tell me where I am. Will you do that?
Yes.
What do you think you will get for answers?
I think people might give me an 8.
8.
Because most people know that I make myself small. But I've already gotten enough feedback that I radiate something else.
How do people justify in their world that you're making yourself small? Why don't they demand you be as you are?
because I choose to go in this depressive state.
So that
everything remains dead and kind of predictable.
So that.
So that I can feel a little bit like tranquil inside. So that I don't have to confront things and actually engage with people for real.
I have a different theory. I think you're still functioning in the construct that you need to do that so you do not get beaten with a wooden spoon. Experiment number two, you go into the market, Puerto Morelos, and you buy yourself a big wooden spoon. And you bring it home and you keep it on your desk, you keep it with you for a while, and then you gather together with 10, at least 10 other people who are not children, or adult people. So doesn't matter, it could be even neighbors, you know, but they need to be, and have a ceremony. And just tell people that when you were a little girl, when you would show up powerful and be yourself and be alive and be curious and be authentic, that the adult figures in your life would beat you with a wooden spoon. Your mother especially, and that you learned how to adapt to that environment in order to survive, and it worked. But that's this time is over. This time is over. And in front of everybody, you break the spoon. You break right over your knee. And if you can have a little fire there, it would be great to be able to just throw the thing in the fire then and burn it. Could you organize that for yourself?
Yes.
Okay. Let me know when it's done, all right? When you do it.
All right.
Have people take some pictures when you're breaking the spoon, maybe even a little movie. If you could film when you're breaking the spoon and placing it in the fire. You know, you can have respect for the spoon because it was a form of communication. It was a constricting factor. It was an element in your life, that spoon. You always knew where it was in the corner, you said. And so, yeah, it's an element of your life. And so it helped shape you into what you are. So the spoon did its job perfectly. Understand? It was just a spoon and it did its job perfectly. So you can respect the spoon and you can break it as a symbol and burn it. That, but you do it with respect, not hatred. It's not the spoon, it was you. That you could have burned that spoon anytime. You could have broken it anytime. There would have been consequences, but you could have done it.
Yeah, I chose not to do it and I can choose to do it now.
Will you close your eyes? Just close your eyes right now. Tell me about the black stuff.
The black stuff feels like a cloud here. It's up here. Oh,
Okay.
Now.
Say hello, say hello, black cloud.
Black cloud.
What does it say? Say thank you for being there.
Thank you for being there.
What does it say? What does it say?
Thank you for being there. It says, fuck you. I think it just shows its teeth.
Okay, so it's a black cloud with teeth.
Yeah.
Say, have you fulfilled your purpose?
Have you fulfilled your purpose?
What does it say?
No.
What was your purpose?
What was your purpose?
What does it say?
To blame things on yourself.
So that what? Say that.
So that what?
What does it say?
So that you could keep growing. And so that you wouldn't blame things on your parents.
You get that?
Yes.
Say, thank you for saving my life. Tell it
thank
that.
You for saving my life.
Yeah. What does it say?
You're welcome.
Yeah. Yeah. That was its real purpose, was to save your life. So you blame yourself. And so you have, so your parents wouldn't just, they'd still take care of you. It was really intelligent, Naomi. It's really smart. It's very clever. Very effective.
I'm feeling joy.
It's fine. You did. You succeeded. It did its job. It did its job.
I've never felt joy in a process before.
What's the funny part? What is the funny part?
The funny part is that it's actually not also serious and scary as I thought, and it's less of a victim place to be. Like, I did it myself, and it was even for a good reason.
Yeah, it was for a good reason, but it had to be scary. It had to be this dark thing that's like, blame yourself. It had to show you teeth, had to be confusing, had to obscure things. It's obscuro, you know, the dark obscuring thing so that you could blame yourself and survive. Look at the black teeth thing and say, well done.
Well done.
What does it say?
Well done. And it says, thank you for recognizing me now.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you for not hating me.
Yeah. Tell the black cloud thing, say, look, in the last couple of years, I have learned some new ways to take care of myself.
Look, in the last couple of years, I have learned some new ways to take care of myself.
and I'm not in a survival situation anymore. I'm in a living situation. I get to live.
I'm not in a survival situation anymore. I'm in a living situation now. I get to live.
And there's another little girl or boy somewhere who needs your services, your excellent services.
There's a little girl, another little girl or boy somewhere that needs your excellent services.
So even though part of me will miss you, I'm going to ask you to depart from me and go be, help them. They need you right now. They really need you to save their life like you did for me.
And even a part of me will miss you. I need you to be part of me because someone else out there needs your excellent services for growing purposes.
Yeah. To survive. They need you to survive.
I need you to survive.
What does he say?
He says, thank you for letting me free. Thank you for setting me free.
Yeah. Yeah.
And letting me go to be out there.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'm making my clicker. I'm making a hole in the golden cube around us, the safe space. He can just float right out that hole right now. And you just take with your two hands, you kind of gather up that cloud, hold it out in front of you, and then just kind of let him go. If you can turn the camera the other way, can you turn the camera the other way, sideways? Yeah. Yeah, good. You just kind of grab him with your two hands gently, hold him out in front of you and look him straight in those teeth. Look straight in those teeth. And by the way, tell him, you've got amazing teeth. They really freaked me out.
You've got amazing teeth. That really freaks me out. And I'm creating a black space. And a golden cube around us.
No, I'm doing that part. You don't have to worry about it. I made a hole in it. It's just a gap.
Around us and a black hole.
No, it's no black
hole. Black gap.
It is no black gap. It's just a hole so he can get out of the cube. We have a golden cube, okay? And I'm just cutting a hole in it so he can escape and go to this other little boy or girl. It's not black, just an opening. Okay.
All right. It's not a black hole. It's a hole here.
Yeah.
In this golden cube. And you can just go there.
Does he say anything?
Find your way to the little girl or boy that needs you. Are you not hearing me?
I hear you.
Are you hearing me?
Yes. Is he saying anything? What does he say?
He says, thank you for the ride.
Thank you for the ride.
He said, okay. Thank you for the ride.
Okay, and let him go.
Yeah. I love you. Yeah. Bye.
Okay, I filled the gap in the side. And I would like you to reach into I filled the hole, so it's now closed again. He's gone. I just patched up the hole in our cube. Please reach into your bag of things and pull out a large pearl of your own golden energy and information and drop it down your spine into your center. Yeah. Let it fill up the place where he was occupying. It's a cloudy space up there. Do another one, okay? It's your own energy and your own information filling up this space where he was occupying. This is the first time. How old were you? How old were you when you called in the black cloud? How old were you when you first started to feel
five.
Five, okay. So since you were 5 years old, you have not had your own space in there. It was co-occupied with the black thing. Okay, put in another pearl, okay? Put in another one. So you're just filling up the space where he was with your own energy and information. It will feel different. The inner balance will be different. You will have a different relationship to people and things and spaces, because it will be, you'll have your own energy and your own information.
I'm going to put another one up here.
Okay, keep your eyes closed for a second. You have some stuff to do. You've got this list of 20 people to talk to. You have this ceremony to create. And I don't know, could you? I think it would serve some people if you could write a little article about this black cloud thing. You know, how old you were, what happened, what was going on, how you created this and installed it, and how it worked, you know, what it did to you, how it saved you, and then how you recognized its purpose finally, and that as an entryway and further into adulthood, that you could, you know, finish complete with it and send it off to help somebody else. That would be, if you could write that up as like just an article to share with people. Sure. Yeah. Do you have a place you normally publish articles?
I'm working on that.
All right. Do you do emotional healing processes for other people?
I've done a few and I haven't been doing them. I want to start doing them again.
I think that the black thing was in the way. And I think it'd be fantastic to do a lot of them. I think it'd be really important for you to do, like, if you just set your mind on 100, start, you know, have a little place in your beat book and just start listing up to 100. It's so great.
Also, this is that I hold space for.
Yes, for other people. Yeah. Great. Naomi, anything else right now? Don't be surprised if in the next months that you are far more angry than you've ever been before, like that it really comes out. And welcome your anger. Just welcome it. And just say, what do you have for me? What's up? What do I need to change? What's not okay? Figure out if it's an emotion or a feeling.
Yes.
A lot of it will be feelings for you. It will call you to action. There'll be some action to take, small action, bigger action, some action to take. And if it's an emotion, then go thank you and then check it out. Put it in your beat book in the back for some emotional healing process, whatever it is. But just, you have uncorked the anger. You did fantastic. That worked. Great. Anything else right now?
I'm staying connected to the sensation of power, basically in my body.
Yeah.
As an anchor point.
Yes. Yeah, but it's inside your bubble. The first time that you've had only your own energy and information in there. And when you drop those golden balls in there and they explode, they push out all the other people's energy, goes back to them. So yeah, enjoy the hell out of it. It's like, it is such a great feeling. It is such a great thing. You got a lot of nature around where you are.
Yes.
There's a road between Puerto Morelos and the town. It goes through a swamp. Do you know what I'm talking about? There's more shops in the town, but I just need you to know that the road that goes through the swamp is full of alligators. Did you know that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah,
I encourage you to take a bike through there or a car or a bus and not really walk through there. All right. I walked through there once and I saw this big old crocodile alligator thing, and I didn't realize that I was stupid to walk through there. That's why there's no local people to walk on that road. It's just full of crocodiles. Okay, so don't walk through there, all right? Just take a taxi or something. Okay, good. All right. All right. See you later.
I honor what I have learned and exchanged with you here. Thank you. And see you around.
Okay. Bye. I will leave. You can stay there and have a good time.
All right. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.